This is the continuity of my previous lecture. In our last lecture, we have discussed subject-verb agreement. For subject-verb agreement, we have first of all defined what exactly subject is. For subject, I have told you it can be subject is a word or a group of words which either does some work in the sentence or about which something is said. And for verb, I have told you that verb is a word which shows us state, quality, existence, and position of an action with respect to time. For the connection of a sentence, a subject must agree with the verb in terms of number and in terms of person. We have discussed certain rules of subject-verb agreement in our previous class, and today we will discuss some more principles of subject-verb agreement. Rule number 7 is, if two subjects are connected by either or neither nor, and one of them is singular and the other is plural. In the previous lecture, we have discussed when two subjects are connected by either or neither nor, and both of them are singular, the singular verb will be used. And if both of them are plural, plural verb will be used. And in this case, we will discuss if one of them is singular and the other is plural, then what happens? If two subjects are connected by either or neither nor, and one of them is singular and the other is plural, in such case, verb agrees to a subject nearest to it. If a subject nearing to the verb is singular, singular verb will be used, and if a subject nearing the verb is plural, plural verb will be used. Look at the examples. Either the students or the teacher are responsible. Now, the students is one subject, the teacher is another subject, and this is the verb. The subject nearest to verb is singular, so singular verb will be used. We say either the students or the teacher is in the class. Rule number 7, look at the example number 7. Neither my sisters, this is one subject, nor my mother. So subject nearing to verb is singular. Singular verb will be used. Neither my sisters nor my mother was home. Look at the third example. Either the customers or the shopkeeper. Now customers is plural and the shopkeeper is singular. Subject nearing verb is singular, so singular verb will be used. Either the customers or the shopkeeper tells lie. Neither the teacher nor the girls. Look here. The subject nearest to verb is plural, so we will use plural verb. Neither the teacher nor the girls have done their job. Look at the next example. Neither the teammates nor the coach. Now the subject nearing to the verb is singular. The coach is singular, the verb will be singular. Neither the teammates nor the coach was serious. So in this example, in this rule number 7, what we have discussed, when two subjects are connected by either or neither nor, and one of them is singular and the other is plural, verb agrees to the subject nearest to it. Teacher is nearing the verb, it is singular, the singular verb will be used. Either the students or the teacher is in the class. Neither my sister nor my mother was home. Either the customers or the shopkeeper tells lie. Neither the teacher nor the girls have done their job. Neither the teammates nor the coach was serious. Now moving ahead, we will move towards our rule number 8. Next rule, that is rule number 8. If the subject of a sentence contains one of, none of, either of or neither of. The noun after them, the noun following them will be plural and verb will be singular. So look at the two things we will discuss in this part. Noun after one of them and the verb. Noun after one of, none of, either of, neither of, noun after them, they are always followed by the noun, and noun phrase after them will be plural and verb will be singular. Look at the example. One of my sisters, her sister lives in USA. So one of after this noun will be plural. One of my sisters. Noun will be plural and the verb will be singular. One of my sisters lives in USA. I have told you when we add S R E S to the verb, it becomes singular, and when we add S R E S to the noun, it becomes plural. None of my friends. Noun after none of. Noun after one of. Noun after either of. Noun after neither of will always be plural. None of my friends and the verb will be singular is a noun. None of my friends is a noun. Either of books, we will not choose book. Either of, noun after either of will be plural. Either of books is missing. Noun will be singular, verb will be singular. Neither of my brothers. Now verb will be singular, was there. So what we have discussed in this rule, if the subject of a sentence consists of or contains one of, either of, neither of, or none of. Noun after them, a noun phrase after them will be plural, and verb following them will be singular. So one of my sisters lives in USA. We won't say one of my sister live in USA, but we'll say one of my sisters live in USA. None of my friends, we won't say none of my friends, but we will say none of my friends is a novelist. We won't say either of book, but we'll say either of books is missing. Neither of my brothers was there. Stop.